from the Russia investigation. The Fox News senior judicial analyst, Judge Andrew Napolitano. Just amazing, amazing revelations being made in the last 24 hours.
Incredible pressure is being put on the Attorney General. Now, I understand that this pressure has been put on him before and that he twice submitted letters of recommendation after the president...
Resignation?
Yes.
Right.
And the president took those letters and wrote rejected and had them hand-delivered back to him. I don't know if the president would reject it this time around. Now, 2020 is hindsight. He should never have accepted the appointment as Attorney General. Or... once he decided to recuse himself, he should have offered his resignation right then and there, because he is a witness in more than one aspect of Bob Mueller's investigation. And you can't be a witness and the boss of the prosecution investigation in which you are a witness at the same time.
I obviously, it's hindsight, but should he have brought that up during the interview process?
Yes. Yes, he should have. What he really should have done was said, you know what, I'm going to stay in the Senate. This has been a lifetime dream of mine. It's tough to do because almost all lawyers in this end of things, in the public policy end of things, would love to be the Attorney General. But, Mr. President, I am just too intertwined in this Russian thing to be the Attorney General. Now, look, this is the most important investigation in the Justice Department right now. The Attorney General has nothing to do with it. Every time the president meets with DOJ officials, the attorney general is not there. There's the impression that he's not running the Justice Department, and the president is entitled to an attorney general he can talk to freely and that runs the Justice Department the way the president wants it run.
Now, this pressure, is it enough now? Apparently, it has caught the eye and attention of Robert Mueller. What are the legal ramifications of President Trump pressuring Jeff Sessions or being upset at him? I mean,
okay,
is there some sort of ramifications?
A great question. Can the president pressure the attorney general to leave office? Yes. Can the president fire the attorney general? Yes. Can he do that because he wants another attorney general, one that he can talk to, one that runs the Department of Justice? Yes. Can he do it because he wants to influence the outcome of the Mueller investigation? That would be very dangerous for the president. It is the purity of motivation that turns lawful behavior, firing Jim Comey, into obstruction of justice, firing him because he wouldn't stop investigating Mike Flynn, to give you an example.
Could he pull his recusal? Is it too late? Has he crossed the Rubicon in that?
He has. Yeah. I think it would violate Department of Justice regulations. In fact, he's even deeper in as a witness now than we thought he was at the time of the recusal.
Trey Gowdy, of course, is on television, and he said he understood President Trump's frustration with all of this, which sparked President Trump to put out a series of tweets making this another major news topic. So where does it go from here then? There's so many different balls being juggled, and it's so hard for everyone to keep track of it all.
Well, you know, if the president were to fire Jeff Sessions, he'd have a very difficult time getting a new attorney general confirmed. The acting attorney general would be the same person that's running the Justice Department anyway, Rod Rosenstein, under the law. The deputy becomes the acting. He could stay as the acting for the rest of Donald Trump's term. So I don't know what would actually be accomplished by firing Jeff Sessions other than removing him as a foil for the president.
But to your point, if he submitted two resignation letters and they were rejected, and we've heard from a lot of people in President Trump's inner circle saying that Jeff Sessions won't be fired, can we take a sort of comfort in that and just know that President Trump occasionally will speak out loud or think out loud via Twitter saying, I think I made a huge mistake here?
Yes. From time to time, I think he will do that. And as difficult that is for Jeff Sessions, I don't think he's going to submit another letter of resignation unless he's told they're going to fire you in 15 minutes. So if you want to resign, you can resign.
What's a typical term? They don't usually ride, usually they last for a couple of years or so.
They usually last. I mean, Eric Holder lasted for 4 years. Loretta Lynch lasted for 4 years in Barack Obama. John Ashcroft lasted for 4 years, the first term of George W. Bush. He had two attorneys general in his second term. It's usually 2 or 4 years.
Right. So it wouldn't be uncommon then at some point, perhaps next year, if Jeff Sessions were to gracefully bow out.
The time to do so would be whenever the Mueller investigation is over, either by exoneration or by prosecution or however it ends.
This doesn't change, though, the Mueller investigation.
No, but a new attorney general would, because a new attorney general would not have that conflict and would remove the need for a special counsel. The president knows that. The Senate knows it, too, and that's why no new attorney general is going to be confirmed until the Mueller investigation is concluded one way or another.
Judge, thanks a lot. Really appreciate it.
Anytime, Charles. Right. Always a pleasure.
Let's start with the New York Times. I mean, where do we go with all of this?
Well, the New York Times is desperate, but Robert Mueller must really be desperate if he thinks that scolding the attorney general over his wrongful recusal is somehow obstruction of justice. Under the law, obstruction requires a corrupt purpose, and as Victoria pointed out, a lie, threat, bribe, destruction of evidence, or altering of documents. Scolding your AG because he was dumb in relying on the wrong regulation in his recusal,
as Greg has pointed out for months and months now,
is not obstruction of justice. And so, you know, this just underscores what a colossal waste of taxpayer money Mueller has caused us.
But as I ask Victoria, let me ask you this. I mean, we now know many of the facts that are fundamental to the special counsel appointment. We know, for example, Rod Rosenstein. There is no question about his conflict, the series of conflicts, profound and disqualifying conflicts that he had,
right,
whether it pertains to Mueller, whether it pertains to the very idea of being a special counsel. The country understands the corruption, the abject, profound corruption of the Department of Justice leadership and that of the FBI. The five top officials in the FBI are gone. Why do we persist in this? Why are we in the media supposed to pretend, even though we certainly do not, but anyone in this media pretend that this is just a perfectly rational process in history in which the President of the United States, Donald J. Trump, is being persecuted by the deep state and the Democratic Party?
Americans now are beginning to realize that the president is the victim, not the villain here. That there was never any evidence of a crime to justify a criminal investigation, no legitimate intelligence to justify a counterintelligence investigation. And Americans are turning against Robert Mueller and James Comey. The latest CBS poll found a majority of Americans believe this investigation is politically motivated, and Americans are right, it is.
No question about it. Let's turn to Jeff Sessions. The president today saying point blank, and this is one of the many things that we love the president for. I mean, he just said straightforwardly, I don't care what you call it. I wish I'd chosen a different man to be, or woman, to be the Attorney General of the United States. And certainly, my gosh, when you look at what Jeff Sessions has done and the way in which he's gone about it, anyone in their right mind would say, what have I done here?
Yeah.
Watching him perform.
Yeah, I've called him
not perform.
A feckless attorney general, and that's a generous assessment of his skills. He has no skills. The president is rightfully angry because Jeff Sessions, while he was standing there taking the oath of office, knew that he would be recusing himself. He testified before Congress that the very next morning he met with officials at the Department of Justice to put in motion his recusal, and again, he relied on the wrong regulation in the recusal. But he betrayed the president. He wasn't honest with the president about that. He should have told President Trump, here's what I'm thinking about doing. And the president said, hold on a minute. This is an important investigation. You need to be in control of it. Let's look at the law. And they would have concluded, oh, I don't have to recuse myself in a counterintelligence probe, only in a criminal case. And it was then not a criminal case. So, you know, this was a severe and serious betrayal of the president of the United States. No wonder he is angry. I'd be doubly angry.
Yeah. It's this president is measured. He's shown patience of an extraordinary degree and he still is assailed from 360 degrees from every quarter in this country, even though he has a rising approval rating and a base that is so understated by the national left-wing media that it's absurd. But this is really cold comfort, because we are watching a president who could do so much,
right,
if unfettered by these little left-wing deep state gnomes who inhabit much of Washington.
The Democrats, I think, are running scared about this Mueller probe. They're beginning to realize the boomerang effect that it will have in the midterm elections if it persists. Yeah. And thus you had Senator Warner saying it needs to end this year. No kidding, Senator.
Yeah, isn't that a clever thing he did?
Yeah.
He's just got to be just cackling to himself at the old boys' school lounge right now as he's suggested it could wrap up sometime this year. This is the man who, well.
Yes.
Anyway. I'm more upset with Richard Burr, frankly, for turning over the Senate Intelligence
Committee. There are two peas in a pod.